So you have the basic blueprint, you know, and then it's just doing it. It's very hard to, I find it difficult to talk about music because music for me is doing it.
Fortunately for me, Van contacted about doing something together. And I was totally into it. I mean, I've been a fan, of course, for years. I always felt like I would love to do something with him because the way he sings, you know, being a jazz singer and a blues singer and all the stuff that I love, you know. It was so glad that he wanted to do it.
Well, that's why I'm coming to this now, because now, basically, I'm at the point where I don't really care what everybody else wants. I'm doing what I want. Armstrong said, never do a song the same way twice. So that's kind of what always stuck in my head from when I was a kid. Like Prima and Jazz and Armstrong and Scat Singers, it's been a big influence on me vocally.
Well, because of Van and his approach, I don't have to change anything. You know, we like a lot of the same things. So I knew that he's a jazz singer and very similar to the way people play too.
I'm kind of coming back to where I started, which was jazz, blues.
The way that love is new.
It's absolutely a live recording. We knew what tunes we were going to play. We talk about the arrangement, and the band was all where everybody could see each other. It was very spontaneous. It's real improvised, but serious music.
There's also a bit of mind reading involved as well.
Yeah. Telepathic things, yeah. Definitely. Yeah. We started the first tune, and then we were rolling, yeah. Man. It was like, yeah. We got done very quickly, you know.
2 days.
We could have made 10 records.
Yeah.
I mean, just from being in there, because yeah. The vibe was so great. Van, I think everything on here is one take.
That's right, yeah. We were having a lot of fun as well, that's for sure.
Oh,
yeah.
And every time I put it on, I feel that same vibe.
Well, see, that's the difference between jazz and the rest of it, because it's all happening now.